The surface anatomy of the neck was explained earlier with this diagram. So this will be familiar to you. And you know, this is a sternocleidomastoid muscle, which is a major muscle in the neck. From the mastoid prominence and also from the lateral half of the superior nuchali, coming and getting attached to by two heads. One is a sternal head attaching to the manubrium sternae and a clavicular head attaching to the clavicle. So sternocleidomastoid, and this muscle divides neck into an anterior compartment and a posterior compartment, which is again divided into different triangles of neck. Okay, so it is on triangles of neck. It is very important topic. So I explain on anterior triangle, which is further divided into submental, submandibular, carotid and muscular triangles, and posterior triangle is again divided into a superior occipital triangle and inferior supraclavicular triangle. Okay, of the same, the chin up or the neck extended picture, so that you can get a clear view of submental triangle. So of the anterior triangles of neck, the first one is submental. Submental triangle, we can also call it as a suprahyoid, because this is hyoid bone. This one. So suprahyoid, above the hyoid bone, suprahyoid triangle, otherwise called a suprahyoid. Okay. So what are the boundaries of submental or suprahyoid triangle? What is this? Chin. So apex is formed by chin. Before that, actually all the triangles are paired. It is because there is a midline raphe, all these are paired, right and left. But for the submental triangle, for all practical purpose, we take it as an unpaired one. Okay, so otherwise we can also tell it as an only unpaired triangle in the neck is submental triangle, because the two lateral boundaries are actually the anterior belly of digastric. This one, the digastric muscle, has got an anterior belly and a posterior belly with a common tendinous attachment to the hyoid bone. Okay, so this is anterior belly of digastric. And this posterior belly forms the posterior boundary of submandibular triangle. That I'll explain later. So digastric muscle, anterior belly of two sides. They are the lateral boundary. And in between, this part is the submental triangle. Okay, so apex is formed by the chin, and the below there is a hyoid bone. On laterally, there comes the anterior belly of digastric, and what comes in the floor? What is this muscle? Fan shaped or a very flat muscle. That is mylohyoid muscle. That is very important. Mylohyoid muscle, which is very important muscle in the neck. It forms the floor of the submental triangle. Mylohyoid. Because actually this mylohyoid muscle is originating from the mandible, near to or in front of the lower molar, and molar, it's a Greek, in the Greek terminology this mylo means molar. Okay, so as this muscle getting attached in front of the lower molars, so it got a prefix of mylo, because molar. Okay, don't forget that. So this mylohyoid muscle originating from the mylohyoid line of the mandible, from just in front of the lower molar, on both sides there are actually two mylohyoid muscles, and they are coming. It's actually a flattened triangular muscle coming and attaching to a median raphe, mylohyoid raphe. Mylohyoid raphe and to the body of hyoid bone. Okay, so from the mandible to the hyoid bone, that is mylohyoid muscle. So of the submental triangle, apex formed by the chin. On both sides, the anterior belly of digastric muscle and hyoid bone below, and the floor of this is formed by mylohyoid muscle. Okay, and what are the contents of this triangle? Okay, now you know the boundaries. Any doubt? It's very evident, right? So chin, hyoid bone, right and left, anterior belly of digastric, and the floor is formed by mylohyoid muscle. Okay, then contents. What are the contents? All are related to a term of mylohyoid. Okay, and also submental. So one is a submental lymph node. I am sure majority of you have seen submental lymph node. Patients come, it's a very common presentation. Any infections of the oral cavity or the midline of the lip will cause enlargement of the submental lymph node. So the one thing coming here is a submental lymph node. Okay. And this submental lymph node drain from the floor of mouth, that is one. Okay, so the floor of mouth, one. Second, central area of the lower lip. Okay, central area of lower lip, this part drain into this submental lymph node, and also the apex of the tongue. So this submental lymph node drains the floor of oral cavity and also the central area of the lower lip and also the apex of the tongue. They drain into the submental lymph nodes, and from there the submental lymph node drain into submandibular lymph node, and from there the lymphatics will go to the upper deep cervical and then in turn to internal jugular chain. And any affections of these areas will cause an enlargement of the submental lymph node, and it is submental lymph node is not commonly affected by tuberculous lymphadenitis. Okay, it is not commonly affected by tuberculous infection. Usually the any infections or malignancies of this area will cause an enlargement of the submental lymph node. So the investigation of choice for an enlarged submental lymph node is, one is a fine needle aspiration cytology, that is FNAC, and the second one is an ultrasound scan, because a type B ultrasound scan has got a high sensitivity and specificity in case of submental lymph node enlargement. Okay, and also there can be chance of abscess, for which we go for an incision and drainage of that area. And the second content is, second, the mylohyoid nerve and also the mylohyoid vessels. It's very easy actually. Okay, mylohyoid nerve and mylohyoid muscle. Because there is muscle is mylohyoid muscle, so the mylohyoid nerve supplies the mylohyoid muscle, and this mylohyoid nerve is a branch of inferior alveolar, which in turn is a branch of mandibular division of trigeminal. It's very easy and simple to remember. It is located near the mandible. So the mandibular branch of trigeminal, again it gives inferior alveolus, inferior what? So inferior alveolar nerve. And from the inferior alveolar nerve comes the mylohyoid nerve. Any doubt in that? It's very easy actually. So the mylohyoid nerve, mylohyoid nerve in turn is a branch of inferior alveolar which is a branch of mandibular division of trigeminal. Okay, and this, what are the functions of this mylohyoid nerve? From this picture also it's very clear that the mylohyoid is attached between the mandible and hyoid bone. So once the mandible is fixed, it elevates the hyoid bone, isn't it? And also when the hyoid bone is fixed, it depresses the mandible. right? So what are the actions? It helps. It's the main user in case of swallowing, mastication, and also for speaking. Okay, I am using my myelohyoid always. Now I am speaking, so I am using, I am elevating the hyoid bone, I am depressing my mandible. So the myelohyoid muscle is important in this action. And also while I am eating, while you are eating, for chewing and also for swallowing, this myelohyoid muscle is important. So what will be the effect or the complaint when a patient coming to casualty with an injury of this submental area? When there is an injury of the myelohyoid muscle, like a penetrating trauma or a road traffic accident or a stab injury, so the patient will complain of difficulty in swallowing, difficulty in chewing, and also difficulty in speaking, right? So that is regarding myelohyoid nerve, which is the second content, and the third is vessel, both artery and vein. Okay, which are branches of facial artery, facial. Okay, so these three, submental lymph node, myelohyoid nerve, and myelohyoid vessel, are content of the submental triangle. So that is comparatively an easier triangle of the anterior neck. I said the boundaries as a chin, as a root apex, and the below formed by the hyoid bone, and on both sides there is the anterior belly of digastric, and the floor is formed by the myelohyoid muscle, and the contents are submental lymph node, myelohyoid nerve, it's a branch of inferior alveolar, branch of mandibular division of trigeminal, and also myelohyoid vessels, which are in turn branch of facial artery. Okay. So that is regarding submental triangle or suprahyoid triangle.